for NVIDIA Riva, which is speech AI, and we'll talk more about it in a second. I'm back here with Adi Margolin, who's our product manager on NVIDIA Riva. We were just here interviewing another colleague of ours regarding Parakeet V2, which had topped the OpenASR leaderboard on Hugging Face back in May of 2025. And now we're back with Piotr Żelazko, who is one of our research leads here at NVIDIA, who is going to talk to us about the Canary Qwen 2.5B model, which has just topped the OpenASR leaderboard as number one. So thank you both for joining. Adi, can you first explain what NVIDIA Riva is?
I'd first like to congratulate Piotr and the entire NVIDIA research
Thank
team
you.
for this incredible achievement for the second time. Definitely, they're keeping us busy. Yeah, so Riva is all about the speech modality, getting all of those fantastic models from research, optimizing them in inference, packaging them as a NIM and delivering them, but also adding additional languages and improving the accuracy even further. Yeah, so Peter, maybe you'll tell us a bit more about Canary Qwen 2.5B and this astonishing achievement.
All right, I'm happy to share more. So, Canary Qwen 2.5B, that's the name of our latest ASR model. It's the first ASR model that we build on top of an existing LLM and that we released as part of NVIDIA NeMo team. So, what makes this model special is it is able to use that LLM to achieve improved accuracy, actually better than any model we did before, because it achieved 5.6% order rate on the OpenASR leaderboard, taking the first place. And that's not the end of great things, because it's actually quite fast for its size. It can run over 400 times faster than real time on a single A100 GPU. And it also can run on consumer GPUs easily. So, that's pretty cool.
Oh my God. Okay. What are the benefits of building an ASR model on top of an LLM, Piotr?
All right. So, from the ASR perspective, it lets the model leverage all the LLM parameters that are already there to improve the transcription. So, the Canary Qwen, it's a type of model we call speech augmented LLM or SAON. And in this case, it fuses the Canary 1B Flash encoder with the popular Qwen 3 1.7B language model. And the way it works is it works in two modes. So there's an ASR mode where we activate all of the parameters and the model is able to understand speech and transcribe it in English only for this release. And there's an LLM mode where you discard all the speech-specific stuff we added, and the model has all of the LLM skills it originally had. So it can do things like generate a summary for you or answer the questions about the transcript and so on.
Great. It's actually really interesting to see the modalities of text and audio and vision starting to converge into its single models. So to train a model such as the one that you're describing right now, Piotr, how did you train that based on the text and audio together?
All right. So for the audio part, it was trained on over 200,000 hours of publicly available English speech, and that's web videos, broadcast conversations, meetings, and all this sort of data. It actually includes a data set called Granary that we're going to release soon. And for the text part, as I said before, the model, the LLM part of the model is basically frozen. So all the skills it had, it's still keeping.
Okay. Wow, cool. And then how does that dual mode switching between the ASR and LLM work in production? Are there going to be latency or any other trade-off that you would see, Adi?
Well, actually, it's easier, right? Because it's a one model that can do both tasks, so it's easy. And it's just calling a different API. But you know, just looking at the opportunities that you have now that you have an ASR and LLM baked together, it's just opened up so many possibilities and unlocked so many use cases that you'll see more and more from the NVIDIA team later on this year and definitely next year.
So speaking of use cases, what are some of the specific ones that you can think of, Adi?
I can think about the first one, that me pronouncing Piotr's name in the Polish, so it's really testing my Polish accent. So the LLM, for example, can take all of those variations of me practicing, pronouncing his name correctly, and then fixing it. So this is just one understanding of context and ASR mistakes and things we can start play with. The second one is, you know, in the future, when we'll make things like end of utterance or endpoint of, or who spoke when, or really getting into this boundary of speaker identification, LLM can definitely contribute to that, to the dialogue management, or also just more advanced thing as correcting the ASR and summarizing it, or adding additional tasks based on the transcription that was just made. So expect more from this fusion of modalities.
Wonderful. So regarding this fusion, I think last time we spoke regarding that Parakeet V2 model, that was also open source and commercially available, as is the Canary Quen 2.5b. But what are the plans to create a NIM out of this model? Are there any, Adi?
Yeah, so first of all, Parakeet, again, this model just came up so quickly by Piotr's work. So we were kind of caught by surprise, but just another great achievement. So for as for Parakeet TDT, 6.6b V2, this one is going to be a NIM soon. So today is July 21st, and within a couple of days, it will be a NIM. So go to build.nvidia.com and search for the speech NIMs, and it will be there. As for this specific model that Piotr was working on, we're thinking actually to take the ASR capabilities, and there's a variety of ASR models from NVIDIA, and add that to the Llama Nemotron models that NVIDIA is fine-tuning, and provide a future production model that has both of those modalities together.
Great. So then once it becomes an NVIDIA NIM, so then there will be enterprise-level support, just, you know, all the benefits of for the production use cases like portability and scalability and additional simplicity for to go from, you know, POC to production for developers and more. And I think people can read more about that on our build site that you just mentioned, Adi.
Sure. That's streaming support and streaming support. That's also a major one. Yeah.
Awesome. Yeah. Anything else you guys want to add, or should we wrap up and plan to meet here again for another win? Yeah, I think we're good. So thank you both so much for your time. Everyone, if you're interested in this model, we have some links below. So please check them out. Thank you so much for watching. And thank you, Adi. And thank you, Piotr. Many congrats.
Thank you, Miriam. Bye. Till the next time. Bye, Piotr.